Create in me a pure heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. That's the 51st Psalm, verse 10 out of the New International Version. Good morning to all of you thriving people of God. My name is Pastor Enrique Brooks of Thrive Church, and I thank God for you being here with us today on this Thriving Thursday. Yes, what a wonderful way for you to start your day. Holding fast to your commitment to pray, and we believe at Thrive, a church that prays together is a church that will indeed thrive together. So welcome to the Prayer 365 podcast, where we are on a mission to transform lives through the lifestyle of prayer. I'm so excited to be able to pray with you. I believe that our lives are changing every day. Our minds are being renewed. Our lives are being transformed by the renewing of our mind through this lifestyle of prayer. Now, if you're here and you're brand new to the Prayer 365 podcast, wherever you are, make sure that you subscribe. That way you can join us. We pray daily at 6:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, Monday through Friday. And then we pray Saturday at 8 a.m. for prayer at the altar. And then we pray on Sunday during our Sunday worship experience. Yes, we come together and we pray together 365 days of the year, exactly as it says, Prayer 365. And I tell you, it's not something that we do just simply for show or anything that we do just to simply check off a check mark on our list. No, we do it because we made a decision about 2 years ago that we want to experience God. We want to know Him for ourselves. And guess what? We began to pray daily, and God has begun revealing Himself in the most amazing ways. And I believe that He wants to do the same to you, because they that diligently seek Him, they will find Him. Amen. All right. Let's go ahead and lean on into our devotional for this morning. Good morning to you, Sister Katasha, Sister Lakeisha, Sister Deborah, as well as my brother Zaron and Sister Jennifer. God bless each of you. All right, so we're in a theme this week titled Reset. I want you to say aloud, say, God, I thank you for the reset. Oh, yes, we're changing it up today. Say, God, I thank you for the reset. My brothers and sisters, essentially what we're realizing as we are looking to satisfy the hunger of our souls, what we must do is actually perform a reset on our spiritual palate. Every individual has a physical palate, which is essentially your appreciation for the taste of foods and flavor. But then with each of us, we have a spiritual palate, which really speaks to the quality of our understanding. And so in order for us to really start over or start afresh, because whenever you have a palate, perhaps there are things that you may find pleasurable, things that you find pleasing to your palate, so to speak, but may not necessarily be healthy for you. Like, for instance, you might have experienced bitterness and frustration and betrayal at some point, but perhaps those things were not actually beneficial to you. And so, therefore, we've got to perform a reset on our palate. We've got to change the way that we think. And the word that we understand that really speaks to changing how we think is that we've got to repent. That's what we talked about on Monday, that we've got to change the way that we think. Amen. Repentance goes beyond the apology. It goes beyond the confession of sin. And it speaks to actual change in our minds. My brothers and sisters, we've got to repent. On Tuesday, we lifted up the fact that we must return to God. This is also an expression of repentance. When we are talking about returning to Him, that means that even though we go out and do the work that we do, we may have been given the assignment of God for the season, but we cannot fulfill it without returning back to Him to be empowered for the work that He has assigned to us. We've got to return to him. In fact, we must do this daily. And then on Wednesday, we said that it is important to rebuild. A reset gives us the opportunity to rebuild. Don't be bothered or even offended if you find yourself in a season of rebuilding. David said, "Father, create in me a clean heart, O God. Renew a steadfast spirit in me." That create and renew, as Elder Clark so wonderfully stated last night in Bible study, those are construction terms. It's okay in the middle of a season of life to say, "God, you know what? It's time for a rebuild. I need you to do some extensive repairs in my life." Amen. And if you missed Bible study last night, we talked about, and we won't be talking about this today, but I just want to share it with you. Last night in Bible study, we talked about the fact that God will rescue you. Yes. It's so amazing that whenever we are going through troubling seasons, or perhaps even we began to do something miraculously, something that no one else in our family has ever done before, and we find ourselves sinking in the middle of a miracle, my brothers and sisters, we must recognize that we're drowning, recognize that we're sinking, and cry out to the Father. Cry out to Jesus and say, "Lord, save me." And understand that when we return to him, when we repent, when we hit a reset in the middle of a bad situation, God will rescue us. Amen. All right. So now today, I want to talk to the idea or to this concept of reframing. Yes. If we're going to do a reset, we must begin to reframe. To frame something, it means to give expression to it. Essentially, when I see something that's happening or an aspect of life, I can frame it by expressing what's going on with my words or even with my body language. And so, but if my response to a problem is to say, "This will never work," then essentially that's what my result is going to be. If I say it's never going to work, that's exactly what's going to happen in my life. But if I desire to see better, then I must reset and reframe. I want you to say that aloud. Say, "Enrique," make sure you say your own name. "It's time to reset and reframe." Yes. In other words, I've got to reset and I've got to reframe if I want to see a different result, if I want to see a better result. That means that I got to say it again or express it again in a brand new way. Now, an example of this would be to reframe my problem by saying, "This problem is actually pretty challenging. But you know what? I believe that there is nothing that is too hard for God." Or perhaps you're looking at a mistake or a moment of failure and you're saying, "I don't know if I'll ever be able to recover from this." The way that I would reframe this is I would say, "You know what? I messed that up pretty bad. But guess what? I'm confident of the fact that he who began a good work in me is faithful to complete it to the day of Jesus Christ." 100%. You see how we reframe that, how we expressed it in another way? You say, now, maybe you have problems with your vision. I have problems with my vision physically, and sometimes I can have problems with my vision spiritually as well. I want you to know that if that's you and you have vision problems, you're not by yourself. You're not alone. I want to share with you this story in the Bible about a young man, well, a servant of the prophet Elisha. You see, Elisha, he had really good vision. He was able to see as a prophet what God was saying. And he was able to relay this information to the king. And this gave them a strategic advantage in the middle of war. Now, the enemy, the king of the enemy of the other army, he got upset about it. And when he found out that Elisha had this ability, he sent his army out to go and surround the city. Now, here's what happens. The servant runs out and he sees, oh, snap, we've been surrounded. We've been made, so to speak. Now, immediately he runs back to Elisha. He says, Master, this is what's going on. We've been surrounded. Guess what Elisha says? He tells him, don't be afraid. It says here, those who are with us are more than those who are with them. Wow. I encourage you to have somebody in your life who, when you feel a bit crazy at times and you feel like checking out and going off the deep end, that you have somebody who you can go to, whether it be a spiritual father, a spiritual mother, a friend who's strong in the Lord, to go to them and say, you know what? I'm having a moment. I need you to talk to me. And they can help you to see that greater is he that's in you than he that is in the world. But look at what Elisha did immediately following. Elisha prayed and he said, open his eyes, Lord, so that he may see. And watch what happened. Then the Lord opened the servant's eyes and he looked and saw the hills full of horses and chariots of fire all around Elisha. My brothers and sisters, this servant was able to see because Elisha prayed that God would open his eyes. I want to encourage you today in this moment or this process of a reset that you would pray that God would open your eyes. When you feel as though all you see is negative and all you feel is negative, I want you to pause and I want you to say, Lord, help me to see, because clearly what I'm seeing is all through my flesh. I need you to help me to see what I cannot see. I need you to help me to see that this marriage can survive this massacre. I need you to help me to see that my health will recover. I need you to help me to see that, Father, even though I feel like I'm not enough, that I'm more than enough through Christ who strengthens me. Father, I need you to help me to see. And my brothers and sisters, Apostle Paul, he said this, and I'm going to pray. He said this to the church at Ephesus. He said, I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened in order that you may know the hope to which he has called us, or he has called you, the riches of his glory, glorious inheritance in his holy people. It's so important that we pray that the eyes of our heart, that they would be open so that we can have hope in Jesus Christ. So let's pray today on this Thriving Thursday that we would pray that we would be able to see, that in the middle of this reset, that we would also develop the ability to reframe with the word of God. Father, we honor you. Father, we bless your name on this Thriving Thursday, because God, you are good and your mercy is everlasting. Father, we say these things and we repeat these things because, Father, it's not to remind you, but it's to remind ourselves. Just as we've discovered today, Father, there are moments in life where we feel like we cannot see. Father, where it seems that all we can see is the negative, but Father, we need to see the positive. So Lord, from that place, we posture ourselves and we begin to declare by faith who you are, that you are our Redeemer, that you are a way maker, that you are a miracle worker, that you are our strong tower, that Father, you are our protection, that you are our provider and our healer and our deliverer. God, that is who you are. And Father, today we ask you to forgive us of our sin. Father, forgive us for how we acted when we had the wrong perspective. Forgive us for how we responded to our family, how we responded to our friends and our coworkers and our boss, our supervisors, Father. Father, forgive us how we acted, Father, when we had the wrong perspective. Lord, help us to reframe. Father, help us to see better. Father, help us to see in a new way. Father, one easy way to change our perspective is to have the perspective of praise. That no matter what happens or what comes our way, that we make the decision to honor your name, to give you glory and to tell you thank you, as your word instructs us that in all things we ought to give thanks. So Father, we say thank you today on this thriving Thursday. And Lord, I pray for my brother and my sister, just as Apostle Paul did. That Father, that the eyes of our hearts would be open. That Father, hope would come in our hearts one more time. That Father, we would be able to see the things that we could not see. That we would see that there is another way. That we would see that there is another path. That we would see that there is another opportunity. That Father, there is nothing that is too hard for you. And Father, if you brought us through that last situation, Father, you'll bring us through this one. And Father, we give you praise and honor. And as we close out this prayer, we pray the way that Jesus taught us to pray, and we say, Our Father who is in heaven, holy is your name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. And Lord, give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lord, lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the hand of the evil one. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. And all of God's children say, Amen. God bless all of you. My name is Pastor Enrique Brooks of Thrive Church, and I thank God for you being here with us today on this thriving Thursday. Remember, God didn't make you to just get by. He did not make you to barely make it, nor to struggle or to strive, but God created you to thrive. So my brothers and sisters, make that decision today. Thrive in Jesus Christ. I'm so excited, y'all. We had over 40 people praying with us live this morning. Make sure you invite somebody so that we can continue to transform lives through the lifestyle of prayer. I love you. God bless you. Take care. Bye-bye.